Today I'm going to present the end-to-end demo for multi-cloud connection using Terraform. So we have implemented multi-cloud data transfer usage between different cloud providers, which will improve the overall application performance and reduce the cost by routing traffic locally. Also, customers can enable private localized cloud-to-cloud routing where they need it without investing the time and capex of physical deployment. Here, we are going to create the fabric cloud router and connect it to Azure and AWS cloud and configure the routing protocol. So I'm gonna run this demo on fabric prod environment and in the Terraform provider. Here is the cloud connection example folder. So first we are going to create the FCR. After that we will create the Azure connection. So you can get the authentication key or service key from the Azure portal. So it will, after the connection has been created, it will configure the direct routing protocol and BGP routing protocol for Azure connection. So in parallel, while Terraform is creating Azure connection, it will also create the AWS connection. Here we have also added an AWS patch request to resources, which will include the AWS secrets like access key and secret key to approve the connection immediately after it has been created. Apart from that, customers will also need to provide an authentication key. So after AWS connection has been created, direct and BGP routing protocols will also get configured. So now I'm gonna initialize the Terraform. After that, I'm gonna apply my changes. So here you can see that it's gonna add 7 resources such as cloud router, AWS connection, routing protocol and BGP routing protocol for AWS connection, Azure connection, and routing and routing BGP protocol and direct protocol for Azure connection. Here I'm gonna give the approval by writing yes. So now Terraform will start creating the resources. So in the fabric portal, you can see the updates. Here cloud router has been created. We can see in the cloud router inventory that Terra E2E FCR cloud router has been created. Here the ASN number will be the same for the AWS and Azure connection. You can observe that Terraform is going to create connections in parallel. Here AWS connection is getting provisioned and similarly Azure connection is also getting provisioned. So we can check the connection status from the connection inventory. Like here you can observe that 2 connection has been created. So here FCR to AWS, so A side status is pending interface configuration and Z side status is pending approval, and it is going to change the status during the whole process. We can see all the updates on the portal even though we are in FCR inventory or in the connection inventory. So now here Azure Direct Protocol has been configured and parallelly FCR to AWS connection is also creating. You can see the all changes here. So here it is provisioning the BGP protocol. And in parallel, we can also check the AWS status. Here it has changed to provisioning, and for routing protocol it just changed to provision for direct routing protocol. Now it will configure the BGP routing protocol. You can see here. So now the code is running and it is going to take few minutes to complete the whole process. And meanwhile, we can see all the updates in the Fabric portal. So here, so BGP status is changed to provisioned. So Azure connection creation has been completed. Now it will complete the AWS connection as well. So you can see in the terminal that Terraform execution has been completed and 7 resources have been created. In the output, you can see the FCR UUID, Azure connection UUID, AWS connection UUID, and UUIDs for direct and BGP protocols as well. So in the Fabric portal, we can search for the connection using the name or UUID. So I will search the connection using the UUID which has been printed in the Terraform output. Here is the FCR to Azure connection. We can also search for FCR to Azure connection. So you can see here that A side and Z side status have been provisioned for routing protocols as well. The status is provisioned. For AWS also, A side and Z side status is provisioned, and for routing protocols as well, status is provisioned. And you can also observe that Equinix side ASN number is the same, similar to the FCR ASN number. That is it for the demo part. Thank you so much.